It's kind of like how the computer and electronics industry advanced. In the old days, yes, you could do computing, but it was a big room full of vacuum tubes and complicated machinery. Now we have cell phones and laptops. So what this device allows is bring to pulsing flow cell culture systems this type of capability that used to take multiple large components. Now we can do it with a single small chip that is driven by gravity. You can think of what we developed kind of like a gravity-driven fluidic computer that creates fluid flow that mimics a heartbeat. There's many drugs and therapies that you'd like to confirm has a good chance of working in humans before you actually test it on humans. Now, the problem is that you can grow human cells outside of the body, but depending on how they're grown, the same cells can respond differently to therapeutics compared to how they would respond in the body. So if we can mimic different flow conditions of the body outside of the body, then those same cells will be a better predictor. Pulsing of flow has been recognized to be important by many people in many fields. It turns out the cells seem to have a mechanism that recognizes whether it's in a living human being or not, or whether they're in a healthy or diseased human being or not. And so this microfluidic circuit tries to recreate this aspect so that the cells know, or at least feel, like they're in a healthy person or in a diseased person and respond appropriately. The way this device works is we have the microfluidic chip. It has a tube that connects to the cell culture media inlet. The cells would be injected from a different channel and allowed to attach to the walls of the channel walls. And then after that, you have the fluid reservoirs, you put it in the incubator, and then if you look really carefully on a microscope, you see inside that the fluid is going on and off. I think it will be most useful for drugs that might affect the blood vessel. These can be drugs that affect cardiovascular disease. This can be drugs that affect cancer metastasis. We have microfluidic models of lung disease. So all these types of flow-related human physiology, I think we can slowly start to impact. And then the ultimate goal is to combine multiple organ systems to recreate miniature human-on-a-chip systems eventually. The beauty of this, the system is that there's really nothing that looks remarkable. It's just fluid reservoirs with some small cartridge, and that's it. The amazing thing is that it doesn't look remarkable, that it doesn't require super fancy external things, because it's all embedded in that chip.
Where the electronic device is dissipating a lot of heat, and if the heat can't escape, that means the electronic device gets very hot, and when it gets hot, its performance suffers, and it also can have a reduced lifetime. We invented a way to be able to mix two different polymers.